Well, you don't have to spend a fortune on cleaning products. You can make your own at home. As well as saving money, you'll avoid lots of nasty chemicals and do your bit for the environment. And here to show us how is low-tox living expert Krissy Ballinger. Welcome to Studio 10. First up, you're going to show us how to make a washing powder.
Yes, so usually it's 5 ingredients is all you need to make your own natural cleaning at home. So in a bowl, I would normally make this 5 times bigger at home, so I would have 3.5 kilos, which would last me a while.
Yep. So you make it and put it in a box or something? Or
yeah, or just a container with the lid. So what I'm going to do is add some bicarb powder first, some salt, any kind of salt will do, some washing soda.
Washing soda.
What's
right?
Washing soda?
They're all natural ingredients, great at degreasing, stain removing, and you can find them. I do stock ingredients, but you can find them in a lot of supermarkets as well. Mm-hmm. Some natural borax as well, and some coconut soap. So you can mill your own soap blocks if you like, laundry soap blocks, but a lot of those have extra ingredients in there and fragrance, and we want to avoid fragrances just because of the ingredients they use and we're not aware. And you can contact allergies from washing powders do often come from the fragrance.
I have a couple of very grotty boys at home. One of them has grown up. They're very, boys are stinky. Will this work as well as, because I, you know, just the regular kind of heavy-duty chemical washing powders, will this work as well?
It really does work. And I would use about a tablespoon per load, and it does the job.
So that wouldn't cost very much.
No, it really doesn't. It's probably about 15 cents per load. And when you're only using a tablespoon, you can add essential oils to this. I would add lemon, lavender, or some eucalyptus. But what I prefer to do, rather than add it to this, because it does end up getting washed through the cycle and a few drops won't make that much difference, is for a softener, I don't use traditional softener. We use vinegar at home.
So vinegar?
Yeah.
Doesn't your clothes smell like vinegar?
No, the first few times it smells a bit like a fish and chip shop, but the more essential oils you use, the less, you know, you're going to smell that. But once, it dissipates really quickly. Okay. So I would fill the your little compartment with vinegar, white vinegar, and I'd add a few drops of eucalyptus essential oil to that. And it's cheap and it keeps your washing machine really clean as well. You don't get that slimy sludge building up.
Fantastic.
Yeah, so it's that easy to make your own washing powder. If you have stubborn stains that aren't coming out of your washing, then just a simple paste with bicarb. To that, I do use definitely use an essential oil. So lemon and eucalyptus are my go-tos for cleaning. And then a tiny bit of water until you've made a paste. Mm-hmm.
And rub it on the stain?
Yeah, and it's as simple as that. So rub it on the stain, give it a little bit of a scrub, and don't be afraid of a bit of hard work, because sometimes you do need to scrub and soak, but it's that simple. So something you can whip up really quickly at home. And I do have on my website a few other recipes for brightening clothes that are a little more effective than just the bicarb.
What about the dishwasher?
Okay, so we move to the kitchen and we get rid of our dishwashing, regular dishwashing tablets, and you make your own. So what we're going to add for this, it's 4 ingredients. So we have salt, citric acid, which is excellent at removing hard water stains, and borax, washing soda. And again, you can add your lemon essential oil to that if you like. So I'll add a few drops in there.
It does smell, and you're wearing essential oils as perfume as well. You smell gorgeous.
Yes. My number one tip whenever I run workshops is avoid fragrance as much as possible. So they're smells, and companies don't need to tell you it's their trade secret, what is in their fragrances.
Right.
So
okay.
They can use a list of up to 3,000 different chemicals to add to make a fragrance, really. So okay, if you're having issues with contact allergies, it's a good idea to remove fragrance.
So do we mix this up and do something?
Yeah, and you don't even need to add any water to that. So it's just a powder. Mm-hmm. And once you've mixed that up, you're going to add it to an ice cube tray. Just your cheapest plastic ice cube tray with a little bit of flex in it is good, because you can pop it out quite easily. And I have, you can pop them out if you like.
How do you keep them together, though? How do you keep
it? It's like magic. So this powder will eventually turn into those tablets if you just push those little black silicon bits at the bottom. Yeah.
It smells really nice too. And you know what? It's actually a nice little gift, isn't it? If you put it in a pretty little jar like this with a nice ribbon around it.
That's right, yeah.
It's sort of a homemade gift.
I'm actually writing another book at the moment. It's all about gifting. So it's really great ideas to gift natural products, you know? great for expecting mums and teachers gifts and things like that.
Hard.
So
it's rock
yeah,
hard.
And I only made them yesterday, and as you can see, they're quite hard. So what I would do is I pop that onto the floor of my dishwasher, and I just pop a little glass ramekin on the top shelf with vinegar in it and some lemon essential oil, and that acts as my rinse aid. So
okay. What about the chopping board?
Now
how should
you
we clean chopping boards?
Yeah, well, we obviously don't want to be putting those into the dishwasher. So one of the best ways to give it a clean is just to sprinkle. I've just got a little bit of salt here and bicarb powder, and just grab a lemon. So it doesn't have to be a lemon that's brand new. It could be one that you've squeezed into your water or tea that morning, and just scrub.
So if you're cutting raw chicken, because that freaks me out in the kitchen,
yes,
and the salmonella and all that sort of stuff, if you cut raw chicken on a wooden board and then use salt and lemon, that would be enough to
Salt, well, lemon and bicarb,
and
would you
bicarb
say?
I would be giving it the salt and the bicarb are great at deodorising, and the lemon's going to help with that too and killing bacteria. But you're going to want to really, I would probably actually chop chicken on glass.
Okay.
I would probably save wood for all your veggies and your fruit, and
okay,
and I'd probably chop meat on glass. But that's okay, we're all human and we grab what's closest. So
yes, okay.
Once you've done that, give it a rinse under some really hot water and then pop it in the sun to dry, because the UV is really great for also killing the germs that might be lurking about. So
okay, good advice.
Yeah, and then
to
we move to the bathroom. Yes, we move to the bathroom now, and just a couple of really quick and easy hacks, and cheap as well, is citric acid's brilliant at getting hard water stains off your shower door and also at the bottom of your toilet. So on my website, I have a recipe for these little they're almost like bath bombs, but they're for the toilet. So each night you can drop one into the toilet, and kids love doing it because it fizzes away.
Oh, wow.
And then it just removes all that built up hard water that you get at the bottom of your toilet bowl. So citric acid and bicarb, and then clove. The best thing about clove is that it will kill mold, whereas bleach doesn't.
Oh,
bleach will disguise it, and it just keeps coming back. So it's been proven that clove will actually kill the mold spores. So all I do is grab some citric acid, doesn't even really matter, there's a specific recipe in my book, but just add some clove and citric acid, a bit of bicarb, and just a tiny bit of water to make a paste, and that you see it fizzes.
Oh wow.
Oh, it's fizzing away. Yes.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, and smear that on your shower door, let it dry, give it a bit of a scrub, rinse it off, and after a few applications you'll notice that there's no need for those harsh chemical cleaners that we're so conditioned to grab when we're out and about needing cleaners. And then just as a surface spray, so just a simple bottle with water and vinegar and essential oils. Again, you've got your eucalyptus, lemon, clove, they're all really great for cleaning.
What do we use this for?
Anything, everything. You can clean your glass with it,
the bench down,
your bench top,
everything,
around the toilet.
Right.
You know, the properties in the oils also really do help to kill all those germs lurking about.
It all smells really, really fabulous.
It does.
And to have your hands on these recipes, simply head online and grab your copy of the Little Inspired book. And because we love our studio audience so much, you're all going home with a copy today.
Yeah.
We're excited about that.
Thank you.